There can be no question about that. Kevin Nash occupying the corner office of World Championship Wrestling. I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? He's the boss.
No, I'm not denying that he's the boss. I just don't know what to make of this situation.
Kevin Nash is large and in charge. That's all you need to know.
Well, I'm certainly not going to make the boss bad. Don't worry.
We're all walking on eggshells around here. Are you allowed to call him Mr. Nash? I thought it was Lord and Master.
Oh, that's right. I'm sorry.
Ooh, man.
I really need this job, Kev, you know.
Kev?
Lord Master. My wife's having a baby. You know, we're having a baby in August.
Oh, congratulations to you and Casey.
Thank you very much. But, you know, I really like working here. I like working with Tanae. I like working with Tony, everybody. You know, I'm sorry. I didn't call by the right thing. So, boy.
Next thing he's going to appoint Scott Hudson out on one of his State of the Union addresses.
Let's just get off of that. Let's talk about the wrestling. Please, I'm sweating bullets anyway. Mike Sanders on his way to the ring, fresh from the power plant to face Chuck Colombo.
And these are two youngsters worth talking about. Big Chuck Colombo and Mike Sanders, you know, we've seen him at ringside the past couple of weeks at Nitro and Thunder events, representing the elite of the power plant. Whoa! Cheap shot attempt by Mike Sanders, and Colombo was ready for him.
And I mean ready, with a staggering series of right hands and a full body slam.
Obviously no strangers to each other, these two young men from the power plant. Talk about competition internally in WCW. Whoa! A drop kick! Springboard off the middle rope, and Colombo just leveled Sanders, sent him all the way to the floor.
Did you see the impact on Sanders? He went down like a rock.
But a great example of what I was just going to talk about. The competition internally in World Championship Wrestling. These guys are battling every day at the power plant. Colombo brings Sanders back into the ring and gains a two count. Now, defeating someone at the power plant and then coming out here on a program like WCW Saturday Night, well, that's a difference of night and day.
Absolutely. And maybe you never know if there's a little bit of heat there at the power plant between two guys that never comes to the surface. When you're in the ring, when the cameras are going, Colombo with a two count, when the cameras are on, and you're in the ring on a Saturday night, Nitro or Thunder, maybe some heat you didn't want to display in the power plant can rise to the surface. That looks like it's happening right here with Colombo and Sanders.
Now, this is really the proving grounds for these youngsters.
Oh!
Sanders cut off Colombo in the corner, dropped him over the top rope, and now Colombo's out on the arena floor on the opposite side of the ring.
Colombo may have pulled a hamstring there, pulled a groin, because he really hit hard on that top turnbuckle, or that top rope, rather. Leg not meant to be extended that far. Watch Sanders.
Whoa!
He turned a moonsault from the apron into almost a vertical enziguri. He didn't hit him with the moonsault, he hit him with a boot.
And Sanders, smart enough to drag Colombo by the hair, bring him back into the ring and go for the cover. Gets two before Colombo comes out.
Into the rear chinlock now by Mike Sanders. You know, Monday night, Sid Vicious, by all rights, should face Kevin Nash for the World Heavyweight Championship.
One-on-one.
Exactly. That was the agreement. That was what was supposed to go down. However, the commissioner, talk about abuse of power. Throwing up the roadblock is Jeff Jarrett. Sid has to get through Jeff Jarrett to get to Kevin Nash. But the thing that just really rubs me raw about this is that if Jeff Jarrett beats Sid Vicious, then Kevin Nash is world champion. Explain that.
That's abuse of power right within the NWO. Sanders goes for another cover. Pinfall attempt on Colombo with another two count. Well, he's basically, what he's saying to Jeff Jarrett is, I'm going to throw you to the wolves. I want you to be the roadblock. I want you to try and slow down Big Sid Vicious. And, of course, Sid Vicious is going to have to wrestle, if he beats Jeff Jarrett, twice on Monday night. Well, Kevin Nash is going to be fresh and ready for the World's Heavyweight Championship match. You talk about unfair.
It's entirely possible that Kevin Nash could become world champion. Oh, Sanders got a two count. He could become world champion without ever lacing up the boots.
Never even breaking a sweat. He could sit back in the locker room, maybe in the office of the commissioner, inside, cradled to a small package, and Colombo gets another two count on Sanders.
Oh!
And he gets up and gets trouble with a running lariat.
Did he ever?
That's right, the Lord and Master, Kevin Nash, never has to leave the throne.
Reverse chin lock from Mike Sanders. And that is a slap in the face when you run down the list of men who have held the WCW World Heavyweight Championship. It's a who's who of pro wrestling. To think that Kevin Nash could become champion without ever lacing up a boot. I mean, last January, a year ago, when Kevin Nash lost the title, at least he was in the ring.
Oh, don't remind me of that.
Belly to back suplex, Palumbo. That may be all he had left. These two power plant graduates doing a number on each other on Saturday night.
Who's going to be the first to get to their feet? Is it going to be Sanders? Or is it going to be Palumbo as referee Mickey J puts in the count? Both men are up.
He rocked Palumbo with the right. Make it two. Palumbo staggers. Oh! Right hand for Palumbo. Sanders taunting his opponent. It's just breaking down into a brawl here.
The reason to see the fire, the competition among these two youngsters, trying to work their way up the ladder of success, trying to prove that they belong in World Championship Wrestling.
Now the face down for Palumbo. Sanders slowly back up. Cut him off. Spins and Palumbo ducks the wild lariat. Oh, that's it.
That's the jungle kick. That's his favorite finishing move. Can he follow it up with a pin?
The 6'7 wonder, Chuck Palumbo. Standing sidekick, he calls the jungle kick.
And look at this. He's got more pain and punishment for Sanders. Headed up to the top. Oh my, off the top. Caught him flush.
The shoulder block, back press, up the near leg, and it's over. Chuck Palumbo. Oh man, does he look strong on Saturday night.
A huge step forward for Chuck Palumbo, but certainly no disgrace in defeat for young Mike Sanders. If this is the future of World Championship Wrestling, then WCW's in great shape.
Later on, we will run them down by height and weight. What's going to happen Monday on Nitro?